The Terminal. The Terminal was released in 2004 and is once again directed by Steven Spielberg. And the film has music once again by the one and only John Williams. And the film stars Tom Hanks as Victor Navorski in the leading role. We also have Catherine Zeta-Jones in there, Stanley Tucci, Diego Luna, and Zoe Saldana. And basically, the film tells the story of Victor Navorski, played by Tom Hanks, who is a Kraskovian citizen. I don't know if I pronounced that wrong, but I think he's Kraskovian, something like that. As he enters this airport, this JFK airport, he gets stuck there because basically he can't get to Kraskovia because there's a war going on there and the government there's having a lot of problems, so he can't get to that moment. So Tom Hanks' character, Victor Navorski, is stuck in this terminal, this JFK airport in America, and he can't go to New York, which is right next to him, and he has to stay in this terminal. He has to stay in this airport until the war in Kraskovia is over and he can finally go home. And basically that's the setup for the film. And so for the rest of the film, we watch Victor Navorski, played by Tom Hanks, live in this terminal. Basically, he lives in this terminal for a good lot of months, and basically, as the film progresses, he starts to form a bond with Captain Zeta-Jones' character, and at the same time, he starts to form a bond with some of the staff members who work in this terminal, like Diego Luna's character, and at the same time, Stanley Tucci's character is trying to stop him. He's trying to get him out of this terminal so he's someone else's problem, so he gets arrested. Stanley Tucci's kind of the antagonist of the film, but at the same time, he's a character that probably brings the most comedy to the film. Like, the scene between Stanley Tucci's character and Victor Navorski, Tom Hanks' character, they're the scenes that bring the most comedy to the film, but yeah, that's basically the plot of the film. But some other plot lines are gone. There's a lot more of Stanley Tucci that I just haven't talked about. There's this whole plot line with Diego Luna's character and Zoe Saldana's character, so basically Victor Navorski trying to get those two characters together. There's also Catherine Zeta-Jones' character comes in and out of the film. But yeah, that's basically what the film is about. It's about Victor Navorski, who is a Kraskovian citizen, who is stuck in the film. He has to live there for a couple of months, and he makes a lot of friends at the same time. He infuriates Stanley Tucci's character. That's basically the plot of the film. And yeah, it doesn't sound that interesting on the surface, I'm not gonna lie, but it's actually quite a wonderful film, in my opinion. This is one of the lesser-known Spielberg films. Like, if I ask somebody, have you seen The Terminal, they're gonna go like, what's The Terminal? You know, have you seen the Spielberg film The Terminal, they're not gonna know. And that's the thing. It's one of those lesser-known Spielberg films, but I don't think it's bad in any way. Because, well, it's just quite a nice, sweet film. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna say and say it's the best Spielberg film, but at the same time, I'm not gonna say it's the worst. I actually think it's better than Hook. It's a really nice, fun, and sweet film. If you're gonna go into this film, you know, with a cynical eye and gonna go, that won't happen, that's not gonna happen, that won't happen, that's not accurate enough. You know, the shops in JFK airports are open 24 hours. If you're going into the film thinking stuff like that, you're probably not gonna enjoy the film. If you're going into a film like I did last night when I watched it and just wanted to, you know, I just wanna watch a fun film, I have seen the film before, so I did kind of know what I was going in for, but if you just going into this film thinking, you know, I just want to watch a fun film, I think you'll enjoy The Terminal. I think what makes The Terminal so good, in my opinion, is the lead performance by Tom Hanks. Tom Hanks plays a Kraskovian citizen. On the outside, you might be going, why didn't they just cast a Kraskovian actor? Or why didn't they just, you know, why did it have to be a Kraskovian? But, well, I'm going to be honest, none of that stuff bothered me when I watched the film. In fact, Tom Hanks gives off such a enjoyable performance. When you're watching, you just kind of slips away. You just kind of indulge yourself in Tom Hanks' performance in this film. He's absolutely fantastic as Victor Navorski. Honestly, you know, just the way he plays that character, it's so enjoyable to watch, and it's so kind of wonderful to watch at the same time as well. And also at the same time, watching the bond between Victor Navorski and Stanley Tucci's character, that's quite funny to watch. You know, like I said, that bond kind of brings the most comedy to the film. And like I said, there's a lot of funny scenes between Victor Navorski and Stanley Tucci's character. And also, Catherine Zeta-Jones' character comes in and out of the film. I must admit, I'm not a huge fan of Catherine Zeta-Jones. I'm not really, to be honest, but she was all right in this film. I'd probably say she's the weakest part of the film. Whatever she was in a scene, is just kind of, she plays a character which basically is involved in having an affair with someone else's husband. She wants the husband that she's having an affair with to leave his actual wife, and you just kind of like, you're meant to side with this character, because I don't really, the character's fine in the film. I think she was probably the weakest character of the whole of the film. Stanley Tucci's character, who's probably the antagonist of the film, who you're not meant to like, you enjoy watching because of the scenes between him and Victor Navorski, which he obviously they play off each other. It's quite funny. And at the same time, you have the scene between Diego Luna's character and Zoe Saldana's character, and, you know, Victor Navorski trying to get those two characters together. That's quite a sweet plot line. It's just Catherine Zeta-Jones' character came in and out of it. I wasn't really sure if I was meant to side with her or not. She was a bit annoying, to be honest. She kept going about this husband she's having an affair with. Why won't he leave her wife? And it's just a bit like, really? One of those people? But yeah, she was alright in the film, just, she's probably the weakest character in the film for me. But the thing is, the film has Tom Hanks in his leading role, giving off such a wonderful performance that you just kind of forget everything that's wrong with it. You just kind of sit there and just kind of like, you know what? This is quite an enjoyable, sweet film. And also, Spielberg's direction, yet again, is late in this film. I've watched a lot of Spielberg films recently, I don't know if you noticed, but I watched a lot of Spielberg films recently, and basically, I've started to notice in all of his films, he does these long one takes, these long one shots where he just won't cut the shot. You just see one long shot, it won't cut it, and it'll be introducing a scene or something. And he does the same in this film. There's a lot of long one takes in this film. Specifically, when we first see the terminal, we see Victor Navorski literally enter this airport. And by the way, this airport is one big real set. It was just one big set. I looked it up before I watched the film. I was like, I was looking up what airport is the terminal filmed at, and I found out it's one huge huge set, and that's as impressive in itself, you know, like the film or not. The set design is incredibly impressive in this film. Going back to that scene, you know, where we first see Victor Navorski walk into the terminal, and the security officer's telling him about, like, the terminal and the place, and, you know, the shops and everything, and the scene's all just done in one take, and the camera just follows Victor Navorski, and it swoops around him, and it's just all done in one take, it's just one shot, and it's fantastic. Each entry to the scene in a fantastic way. Yet again, I think the film is directed pretty well, I'm not gonna lie. And also, the meat of the film. This is, again, not your typical John Williams soundtrack. I listen to the soundtrack, like, once every couple of months, because it's a really nice, sweet soundtrack. It's not like his other scores, like Raiders of the Lost Ark or, you know, Jurassic Park, so on and so on and so on. It's not like those scores. It's quite a nice, sweet score. Honestly, the music of the film is quite nice to listen to. It's quite smooth, quite nice, and it's quite, you know, sweet. Kind of like the film itself. It's a really nice, sweet film. Now, there are some sentimental parts in the film, and that's mainly revolving around Captain Zeta-Jones' character, but at the same time, when you had Tom Hanks in those scenes, it didn't really bother me, because he was just... He's so great in this film. I think Tom Hanks is an absolutely fantastic actor. He's one of my favourite actors, and he's so great in this film. He brings so much wonderful joy to his character that even in those sentimental scenes between him and Catherine Zeta-Jones' character, I was still enjoying his performance. And if I was going to take anything out of the film, I'd probably take all the lovey-dovey stuff out with Catherine Zeta-Jones' character, because it doesn't work as well as some of the other stuff in the film. For example, the whole scene where Victor Navorski is using these cards to get quarters so he can go to Burger King and everything, and the scenes where, you know, Victor Navorski is applying for a job, and the world's like, where do you live? He's like, I live here. Again, they're all fantastic scenes, but I just thought there were some, those scenes with Victor Navorski just by himself, or just with the staff of the airport, was so much better than Catherine Zeta-Jones. Own teams just became a bit too sentimental. And also, if I was, you know, being really critical of the film, I would probably take out the last 5 to 10 minutes. Basically, in the last 5 to 10 minutes, I'm going to try not to spoil it because you haven't seen the film, but basically, something happens and I didn't really think we needed that to happen. They could have just left it a bit ambiguous. About 5 minutes before the film ended, there's a scene where the camera just actually zooms out and I thought, oh my god, it's going to cut. This would be a fantastic end of the film. And then it didn't cut. It went off another 5 minutes. I was just like, I don't really need this. Like, don't get me wrong, the last 5 minutes isn't awful. It isn't a terrible ending. I just felt it would have been better if they just left that ambiguous and just on that zoom out, they literally just ended the film. It would have been so much better. At the same time, the last 5 to 10 minutes isn't awful. It just kind of felt disjointed with the rest of the film. Apart from that, though, I do really think this is a wonderful film. This isn't a typical Spielberg film. It isn't up there with some of his classics. I'm not going to lie, this is not my favourite Spielberg film. But at the same time, it is not the worst Spielberg film. It's got a nice heart to it. It's an enjoyable film to watch. Yes, if I was going to sit down and do a full, you know, video essay picking apart every single scene in this film, I could probably notice a million problems with the film. I could probably notice a million flaws. But the thing is, watching this film last night, none of those flaws bothered me. I was just having a really enjoyable time watching this film. It's really nice to watch. The comedy in the film works really well. I was laughing quite a lot in this film, and I didn't expect to. Stanley Tucci is great in the film. All the other staff members are great in the film. You know, even Catherine Zeta-Jones, she's not awful in the film. She's one of my least favourite characters, but the performance isn't awful. It's just not a huge fan of her character. But when you have Tom Hanks as Victor Navorski giving off this fantastic performance, all that kind of slips away and you kind of enjoy the film you're watching. It's a nice, fun, sweet, wonderful film in my opinion. And that is why I'm also going to give The Terminal a 7.5 out of 10. I'm not going to sit here and say it's the best Spielberg film, but I thought it was a wonderful film, a really, really nice film. And different than some of his hard-hitting films. Like, I've watched a lot of his hard-hitting films recently, and as good as those films are, and they are really, really good, you know, most of the time, it was nice watching The Terminal, watching Spielberg doing something different, something nice, doing something sweet, and ultimately, I enjoyed this film. I would recommend it if you just want a nice, fun, sweet film to watch. And that is ultimately why I'm going to give The Terminal a 7.5 out of 10 from me. Anyway, guys, what do you think of The Terminal? Do you love it, do you hate it? Or have you just not watched? And if not, why not? Please do comment below and know your thoughts in the comment section below. Anyway, guys, just to say once again, I'm still watching and reviewing a handful of Spielberg films right now. So look forward to my next Spielberg film review. Haven't said which one's going to be yet, but look forward to my next Spielberg film review coming very, very soon on this channel. Anyway, guys, thank you as always for watching. And if you haven't yet, please do click down below and like, subscribe on this video. And look forward to many more both film and TV and Spielberg film reviews coming very, very soon on the show. See you guys again soon. Bye-bye for now. Bye.